Hello, everybody. This is Agent Kak. Let's continue the robotic recap, shall we? Although Henshin and Heroes of Techman is pretty damn awesome, I am going to actually stay on the desk.
So, it was seen that Toya is finally becoming a man and taking the fight seriously. Hooray for character development! Toya goes on a bit more of a heroic rant while the Count's well girls listen in awe. Meanwhile, in Northern Africa, two people talk about coffee and how anybody that defeated Crusade should not be underestimated. Upgrading time! And Puzzle Robo was Super Trixie Doodle Dandy.
Or possibly not.
Meh, I just love it when I miss things. Okay, let's go on to the next chapter. It's meal time on the Nadesco. Everybody is talking about how the Archangel is doing, but they'll probably be fine without us. They have some powerful troops on their ship, too. So, after a bit of backstory about the Countwell girls, it's off to China to battle the forces of Zaft. After a bit of discussion about the weapon codenamed the Walking Stick, the crew of the Tuatha De Danann decide to go and help us out. So we are suddenly invaded by the Death Army yet again.
It's the Death Army! We're screwed! And a mysterious person who's green. What does that mean?
That green person who destroyed the zombies turned out to be none other than Master Asia, who just so happens to be Domon's good friend and old master. So, onwards! It's time to take down the Walking Stick. So, our first goal is to reach the Walking Stick. But we can't use any aerial attack due to the Walking Stick being active and having the possibility of us being shot down by its powerful cannon-ness. Yeah. And with Domon as a target again, I'm not sure what to do.
Would it be the best thing if Domon would stay behind?
So, it would appear that the Batas are dead set on keeping the cannon safe.
Okay, what do you guys do now? Okay, you three are gonna wait there.
They didn't even move on their turn. Yeah. Some attack where we come within attack range, but those guys are dealt with justly. Yeah. Those guys just don't want to move at all. They don't want anybody near the Walking Stick. Well, I'll just have to make them move by destroying them. Since we're getting close, they decide to attack first. It's a big mistake on their part.
Punch through them? I couldn't think of a good verb other than punch.
Soon, nobody will oppose my march onto the grounds near the Walking Stick.
But wait. I don't know.
Whoosh!
Slash combo. Oh, slash combo vision! Hell yeah! Tearing you apart like you're made of dolphin.
So now that all the bosses are gone, it would appear that I may not need to get into the red area after all.
On second thought, maybe we just need to get into this enclosed area for X amount of turns.
Shit! Even though we destroyed it, we really didn't need to. Yeah. And what makes matters worse, he shows up.
I don't think so. Fuck. It's the Devil Gundam.
Not only him, but also...
Yep, I was doing Master Age is evil.
Luckily, the Shuffle Alliance, one's Dolone, of Master Age's evil intentions. It appears that Master Asia is actually the leader of the Death Army. Alright, Shuffle Alliance, let's go! Let's fight together!
So, you won't help me? Oh, damn it.
Wait! Where'd you go? Fine! Well, in the next stage of the battle, I have a bit more give room. I can survive as long as I have one unit remaining. And since I'm up against that asshole again, I just may be happy the conditions are so loose.
Well, this is a glorious fuffle I have myself in.
Being weaker, Max, the Death Army units only go down in a hit or two. But what really worries me is fighting the Master Gundam and the Devil Gundam in the same battle.
35,000. And Devil Gundam probably has 40,000. And Death Army, Death Soldiers of Death.
And for some reason, everybody is wanting to hit the Mazinger.
Iron Cutter. Okay.
Even Master Gundam.
Oh shit, Master Gundam!
Hey there, Devil Gundam. You may be way in the back, but I can still hit you!
Hell yeah. I can hit Devil Gundam way back here. With his 40,000 HP.
So, eventually, there's just basically Devil Gundam and Master Gundam remaining.
Long story short, we need to kick his ass in his 35,000 HP Gundam. And the Devil Gundam, who I thought I sniped. Does it have some regen factor?
Yes. Yes, it does. At least my strategy is improving here. Well, after a miss, I get to see the true power of the Darkness Finger.
3905? Darkness Finger again? Explode! Welp, he called it.
just hope I don't see that too often. Cause an attack that can do roughly 4,000 plus damage is not that healthy for my troops. Well, okay then. Let's snipe at Devil Gundam again. And finally, the regain factor of the Devil Gundam was discovered.
Wait. Shit. His health refuels every between rounds. What? He turned himself into a green ball of energy with a human head? That's hilarious. That is not hilarious.
Okay, let me do that or the darkness finger again. You know what, Master Asia? How's about you stop attacking me from now on? Don't do anything. Okay? You've hit way too hard, and you are quite the asshole. Don't you have any really nice basic attack that will hit for about 600, 700-ish? That would be really, really nice. Yeah. So, after damaging Master Gundam a bit, I realize that the Devil Gundam hasn't got much hitting love lately. So, my attacks will go towards him for a while. So, the final-ish blow is dealt to Master Gundam, knocking his HP into his retreating range.
I don't know. I don't know what I'm getting at, though.
So then, both Master and Devil Gundam escape the battle. All seems well. But then...
Shit! I'm going to be in a lot of shit trouble. Oh, that's good.
But luckily, those guys were just there to taunt me. Then the Shuffle Alliance shows up again.
Hell yeah, we get reinforcements! Wait! No! Stay and help! Please! Please stay and help!
And then... they leave again, leaving me with 9 more zombies left to fight. Although most of my troops are in a rather poor condition to fight, it's going to be far easier than what I was doing, since it's just zombies. The zombies are dealt with quickly and promptly. For now, the Death Army is destroyed. So, now, on the plus side, the walking stick has been destroyed. On the minus side, Domon found out that his master is 100% pure evil. And on top of that, the PT engines are shot. So we need to be careful where we go. Elsewhere, back on the Tuatha De Dundon, the crew is informed of a girl who may be the target of a kidnapping. And that Kreutz is a pedophile.
Are you some sort of pedophile?
And it's now time for the usual intermission stuff. Okay, everybody. It will only get more intense from here. See you next time on the next part of the recap. So until next time, this is Agent Kak, and I'm saying adios.